In the year 2019, Adeesa support group organization with funding from OFM Germany, Caritas Austria, MFIC sisters implemented a project which trained a number of women in financial literacy in order to empower them economically. And 2 years later, here are the results of that training.
Before the training on financial literacy, they didn't know how to do this thing. They were struggling. And then when Adeesa Support Group Association came to train them on financial literacy, how to keep bookkeeping, to record what they sell, and then to contribute some money which they divide among themselves for when they do business, they return some percentage to the group, and now they are financially okay.
All the love give to me, tell me where would I be without you now? Every time I stumble or fall.
After an interaction with the beneficiaries of this project, we took some time to understand the impact of the financial literacy training. We decided to interview a few of the members. We asked them about how this project has improved their lives.
Before the training, before we provide them training on financial literacy, she was struggling. She was trying to do little thing here, what they call tamia, they get a cassava and make it like a little bread to sell. This was not working. But when Adeesa Support Group Association came and trained them on income generating activities, how to do this little business, how to grow it, even if you get a vegetable and sell, how you can grow it to become a bigger business for you. Then she took that training, and then that oil and this one, this side is her own personal one. So she started doing those little business, and now she's growing, and her life is much, much, much better than before.
I'm batano kusayo ni aduro gira kayo rok makarapa na mikidwa rok bore na mbani gagon kipa nosungo besi kina kumbami yena hefere mikidze ana awele woyere kuko yugo pafere ni magai rutuwa mi adumbata kusanga ile kina kumbami yena hefere mina avile awele kini mungi ulia businessi kama na adua bere ya mikie ki zibafe mina tangbegi mi amira ya kini rungu he kini bogi he Yozuara mina baga hana kamista shararfi a customer kina bere mina ye fore mino tangbe ogule kitorungu ini kande ba logwa kamia.
Before the training from Adeesa Support Group Association and the Franciscan Sisters, she was like, she described herself like a goalkeeper. A goalkeeper waits for a ball to be thrown to him to catch. So she was like that with her husband. She waits for her husband to bring her money or to bring her something. If she's sick, he's the one to bring everything. But after the training on financial literacy, which we are income generating activities. She now able to do some little work. She joined the group, and now she is able to come and borrow money. She buys this because she's very artistic. She buys the material and all this, and she made the thing like this, and she sells it. She has more people, also customers who buys from her. Once she returned the money to the group, the benefit she has got from it, then she continue buying and making this and selling it. So she's now financially independent. She does not depend on her husband. When the husband has something, fine, he bring it. But when there is nothing, she's free to go and buy what she wants. If the child is sick or when she's sick, she's able to help.
So Alice shared that
before the training, she was having difficult problems. She had 7 children when she was just 5 years old. And the children began to die also. There was no way to find money even to help the children to school. When she was forced to cultivate, there was no time. And also she began to develop trauma, stress. Then when she heard about Adeesa support group association, and then she went and then for the training. Because the training for the women to do a great job like this, what we the Adeesa support group association and Franciscan sisters do, we do trauma awareness first with them. After that, and then we do the financial literacy training with them, which we call income generating activities training. So when she did that, the trauma healing program we had helped her to release her stress. And then when we start to train them on income generating activities, which is financial literacy, and then she was able to think, and they started to do to join this group and they start contributing, and then that's when, as she said before, she borrowed the £500, which now has developed her to more pounds, and she's now financially stable.
Tell me where would I be now without
as we are Franciscan brothers and sisters, and I'm very happy and appreciative to my sisters, the MFIC Missionary Franciscan Sisters at the Immaculate Conception, and my brothers, the OFM in Germany, and for their support to us. This first call was brought by the Franciscan Sisters to this group because the difficulty they had was to go to the garden to bring things to sell, or to take things to the market. They have to carry it on their head. So we bought this the sisters gave us money. We bought it just one basket among these women. they live in different places. They have to come to take it and to go in order to do their business, and then it is kept here. But I'm going to ask them, the chair lady, how is the basket helping them? Despite the fact that they are sharing one basket among these women.
For information, it has run Yala, can be able to and the community to go for the running. No, we are going to go to Marana for back there. As you are, you are going to go to Gurame Jutel. And I'm going back there to come home. Yeah. I'm
going
to go to the Gurame Jutel.
So the chair lady is saying that this basket, they cannot use it in the sense that it has to carry things because it's only one and there are many of them, otherwise it will spoil. It is kept here. Now, if there is an information they want to all women, they take the basket and they give the information person instead of walking from house to house, the person will just write and inform all the groups. And they will be here like what happened. The information was passed to them yesterday. And then this basket was given, and now here are the women. So that's the way it is helping them. And also to maintain it, it looks still clean, even though how many since last year we gave them. So they cannot use it that to carry things because there are so many of them. There are many of them. At least if there were five or six baskets, could have helped them, but that's one. Now they decided to open another group. We didn't give them anything. Their zeal of helping women to grow, so they went and opened another group in the vulnerable area, which have set women also in the group. So those set there, plus set there, they are all 60 in this area.
After evaluating the impact of the project with this particular group, we proceeded to the next group that this women group had created to see how this project has affected their lives.
They decided to take this young man to be part of the group so that it would be taking their notes. He said every Sunday they meet and there are 30 people, 30 women. And then every Sunday they bring money. It's deeper here as you see the price here.
When we reached the second women group that we had been told were created by the first women group, we met the women there and one gentleman was among them. However, we did not want to keep them for long because they waited for us for a very long time. And so now we selected two of them to interview them on the benefits of Adeesa Support Group Association to them. And this is what these two interviewees had to tell us.
Ga manga wiria business here and but afu mumwenge gara kaduma
ngira kagado oni ikiteka maji bukuri ani kinia kamanga guria pai gi bakare pai gen ngi ami na zo wiria buda ka baga ni muji wiria tamaka baga
ni
malenga moji
moji
marco
moji marco she said before the training her life was just like this because she has grandchildren who have no fathers. So after joining this training, because she cannot do much, what she does is that she borrows money here and buys something to do the local brew to sell. Before she couldn't do it, but now she borrows, she sells. When she returns the money, the balance is able to help her grandchildren. She That before she became part of this group and before she got the training on financial literacy, her life was difficult. But after joining this group and training, because we trained them first, now her life is good. Is that she come and they borrow money here, she goes and do her little business, and she returns that money, and that money she did the business, she continues the business. The unity among the group here. They decided that now, since agriculture is bringing money also, the group goes to the house of one person, to the field of one person, and they cultivate one fedan. And then if they decided one fedan each, then they cultivate one fedan each for each person. And then they plant things out of this, they sell those things.
So after all these interviews, we asked the women what they had to say to Adeesa about what it has done to them. And this is what they had to communicate to Adeesa.
She's grateful to Adeesa for the good thing they have done to them, especially for her, that we took her from the bottom line and pushed her as far as where she is now.
Okay.
She's very grateful to Adeesa Support Group Association and the Franciscan Sisters for helping them, especially helping her to provide this training that opened her mind to do business, and then also for continue to support her in the group or support the group, visiting them and encouraging them. Alice is the chair lady of this group. She's saying thank you to Adeesa for the training which they have provided them. It has opened their minds, but she's more appreciating because now she's in the group. Working in the group is very good. She knows many people. They share their grievances together. They learn from each other.